It is a beautiful day and we can see it perfectly thanks to the experts in the field of vision. It is Healthy Eye Month and we are honored to have in studio again with us Dr. Carolyn Teske, my holistic optometrist, a real passionate supporter of making our seniors matter, and always welcome back to the show.
Thank you, Margaret. I'm thrilled to be back.
So it is Healthy Eye Month and I know that you really are dedicated to education. And I think we should start out by letting our listeners truly understand some of the staggering stats that eye health have in our country and the impact that can have on lifestyle.
For sure. You know, the Canadian Association was very keen at putting out statistics for May because it is Eye Health Month. 1 in 7 Canadians develop a serious eye disease in their lifetime. So that's a lot of people.
It certainly is. It certainly is. And of course, we talk about seniors here on this show. What is the impact as we age on our vision in terms of stats?
You know, vision really somewhat stabilizes in terms of the glasses that you need. But over 40, you are 2 times the risk of developing eye disease. Over 75, you are 3 times the risk of developing eye disease. And really, you know, prostate cancer, Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, and breast cancer all put together is still less than the number of people that have vision loss to some degree in their lifetime.
That's a staggering stat.
It is, isn't it? Yeah, that's way more than I had imagined it would be.
And we know, we always talk about education here on the show, and certainly this is where you're passionate, Dr. Teske. Vision loss impacts every aspect of our life. I mean, certainly it can put us, you know, prone to falls. It really is a window to our health, is it not?
Absolutely.
It's important to have eye exams for that reason.
For sure. And you know, vision, you can assess yourself. Can I read? Can I see? But there's so much more to that that people don't recognize.
So you're looking at people, we're obviously talking about seniors, so you'd like to see a senior every year?
Absolutely.
For an eye.
And more if needed.
More if needed. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that's really good.
So we like to give practical information here on the show and having tips for good eye health. One of the things I love about being a patient of yours and your team is that you really look at eye health holistically. And I know there are a lot of optometrists across the country that do, but there's some that don't. And what do we mean by holistic? You really blew me away in your office at really giving me more information than just looking at an eye chart and giving me eye drops. Let's speak a little bit to some of the tips that you can give holistically to keep our eyes healthy. What about nutrition?
Absolutely. You know, you are what you eat, right? I think that everybody says that, and it's true, certainly in terms of vision. You know, simple facts, kale's the superfood for eyes right now.
Does it replace carrots?
Absolutely. Now, carrots are good too, but kale's better. So, you know, like a medium leaf of kale would give you what you need in terms of lutein to prevent macular degeneration.
To prevent macular degeneration.
Okay.
So for all of you at home that don't like kale, as I used to say to my dad, rest his soul, it may not taste good, Dad, because he'd say it's green, you know, I'm not a rabbit. If it doesn't taste good, too bad, it works and it's important.
And you can form kale in other ways. I mean, if you made them into chips, would that take away the...
No, not at
all. There you go. So there you go. Kale chips is on. That's good.
So diet's critical.
Yes. And I know in your office you've got an eye essentials drink. And if people want more information about that, they certainly, to make it simple so that you can have a drink that will support your eye health.
Absolutely. That's good stuff. Now, we did talk about eye exams. Is that a costly factor for seniors?
No, thankfully, under OHIP's umbrella presently, seniors are covered for everything that they need.
So often as you need, but at least once a year.
Exactly.
Okay.
Now, what about smoking, Dr. Teske? Does that have an impact on our eyes? We certainly know the impact on our lung health and cardiovascular system. What about our eyes?
For sure. Macular degeneration, we just mentioned, is a leading cause of vision loss over 55.
55.
So we're not really talking about seniors now.
Yeah.
And one of the contributing factors is smoking, sun, and diet, right? So you really need to be careful.
We have a family member who has macular degeneration, and having watched the immense change in the abilities in his life makes us all very sad, because this was a person who used his eyes to build amazing things. So we understand how serious that is, but knowing a little bit more about what we can do preventatively might be hugely valuable.
Absolutely.
And we're coming into the spring and we are seeing sunshine. What about UV protection? What role does that play in prevention?
Yeah, UV is huge in terms of accelerating eye disease, cataracts, macular degeneration, cancers. So, you know, it means sunglasses, sunscreen, hat, you know, before you really go outside.
All of those things.
All of those things.
All of us, including our children, our grandparents, our parents, are more involved with these things now than we ever were. So we play games, we watch TV, we have iPads, iPhones, everything. We're looking at devices all the time, and we spend hours. There must be something we should be doing to make our eyes rest a little. What can we do to do?
That's what makes my job secure. We are in the device world.
We are, right? We are.
So my general rule of thumb for devices is 20-20-20. So every 20 minutes, blink 20 times so your eyes stay hydrated. Oh. Look away 20 feet.
20 feet?
Right. So it's break that spasm of staring at that device.
Good. 20-20 vision has a new meaning. I love that. So 20, blink 20 times, stare away 20 feet. And what about the length of time?
20 minutes.
20 minutes.
So that's not the 20-20-20.
Not to stare for 20 minutes. Yeah.
So every 20 minutes, blink 20 times, look away 20 feet.
20 feet. For how long?
Just that
just
break.
Just that break.
Just that break.
Not for 20 more minutes.
No.
That will get the work done at this rate.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great to know. Good to know.
Really important. Now, what about eye irritation? You know, whether it's allergies, infections, you know, injury, what can we be doing, especially in seniors? I certainly know what a change in my health, my eye health, when you introduced me to high-low drops. My goodness, that was a game changer for me. What about that?
We are so reactive, right, to symptoms, and it really is so much better to be proactive. So absolutely. By the time you feel irritation, you see redness, your eyes are sore, then we're in a crisis, right? Or we're in trouble. Mm-hmm. So rather than wait until you feel symptoms, then you really should be proactive. And that's why I encourage you, Margaret, to get up, brush your teeth, put your drop in, and your eyes should always feel good.
Right? And they do indeed.
So being proactive makes a big difference.
Right. I have diabetes. And for me, that's a big deal with my eyes and the rest of my overall health. So a lot of things can be detected by eye exams.
Absolutely.
That being one of them. Tell
diabetes,
tell us a little bit more
blood
about
pressure,
that.
Heart disease, mm-hmm. cholesterol, cancers, all of those things. You know, the circulation in your eyes is so fragile that we see changes often before patients know. Right? So, you know, the idea would be you can test your vision, you can tell me if you can see, but there's so much more to your eye exam that maybe you don't
see,
know that we can help you.
Yep. And that's such a great point, Liz. Thanks for bringing that up. I know coming to your office, I've had a couple of tests that I've not had when I've been at other optometrist's office. Can you speak to just some of the diagnostic testing that you have available in your clinic that really can paint a picture, both for prevention and also for treatment, to really help?
Absolutely. You know, we talked about the downside of using digital devices, mm-hmm. But the upside is digital world has changed what I can do. So now I can scan the 10 layers of your retina and tell you if disease is coming rather than waiting and being reactive to what I see. So it's almost like an MRI or an ultrasound of your eye. So that's OCT. And of course, we can photograph what the inside of your eye looks like. So instead of my words describing, now I've got a JPEG or an image. And it's that kind of tech.
Fantastic, isn't it?
Well, it's such a patient education tool, which is what I love, because you as the optometrist can actually visually show me. And it's a marker and a motivator to want to do something. If we can't, seeing is believing. And if we don't understand the impact that we're having, some of these things are insidious and we don't know until we're in a crisis. But some of the technology that you offer in your clinic really does provide empowerment, I believe, for patients like myself.
Thank you. Yeah, our tools are so much better, right? This is my 20th year in practice, and really things have changed dramatically.
So gone are the days of the big machine with all of the...
Well, we still use
that,
lenses.
But that was pretty much all we got, right? Between
that's
that
right.
And look
couple
at the wall,
flashlights.
Like the same letters that we've been looking at for the last 30 years. Kind
exactly.
Of without any more to the exam than that. So now it's changed tremendously. So we're going to highly recommend that our seniors out there and their families get their eyes tested. Find out what their baseline is today or how they're doing today, and especially think of it as part of their overall health.
Absolutely.
As opposed to just about eye health.
Absolutely, and how it can impact their lifestyle. So one of the things we're really excited to announce here on Making Our Seniors Matter is that we are actually going to have an Insight on Eye Health series that we're very excited. So it'll be a television series that we'll be sharing, and we're honored to be able to bring Making Our Seniors Matter into that equation and really talk about eye health holistically. Now, Dr. Teske, we're very excited about this because we're all about sharing education, not just for patients, but for other optometrists and healthcare professionals Because if we're going to be patient-centered, we need to get media assets out there to educate. Can you speak to some of the partners we have for this project? Because without them, it wouldn't be possible. And how, you know, Making Our Seniors Matter is going to be able to play a big role in this.
I share in your passion, Margaret. You know, education is key. I can educate the person in my chair, but with the help of TLC and Dr. Dean Smith and Nikon and AMO, who share our passion for education, we're going to be able to not only teach people in my chair and on radio and via Making Our Seniors Matter, but thousands, you know, of patients will access this information.
As well as optometrists across the country, which is great and exciting for Making Our Seniors Matter, because these media assets can be playing in the waiting rooms across the country, which is so exciting. You are always full of such great information, and I know a huge ambassador for Making Our Seniors Matter. We really appreciate your expertise and your passion for education. And coming up, I know you ran here from seeing a patient this morning. Not physically ran, you drove. She does, she's a runner though, so she
might. That's healthy too.
But thank you so much for continuing to support our passion here at Making Our Seniors Matter, of just making seniors' lives just a little bit better.
My pleasure.
Truly appreciate it, thank you.
You're welcome.
Stay tuned as we've got more coming your way here at Making Our Seniors Matter.